We've made a lot of advances in prematurity, which affects about 11% of babies. The most critical organ system initially is the lungs. So if the lungs are severely immature and small, and we can't support that oxygen delivery with the ventilator, the babies can't survive. Why don't we solve the problem of prematurity by recreating the intrauterine environment or developing what was initially called an artificial placenta?
The use of the artificial placenta allows the heart and the lungs to grow and mature to the point where they can totally support the baby. Now, this particular project is aimed at very premature infants where conventional ECMO has not been very successful. It causes too many problems. So we focused on modifying the ECMO system to manage very premature infants. The unique thing about this particular approach is that it maintains the fetal circulation. And many of the problems with premature babies is we have to force them to convert to normal neonatal physiology at a time they're simply not ready for it. So the artificial placenta is designed to maintain the fetal circulation, no blood flow to the lungs, for example, until the baby's ready for it.
So this is really a complete paradigm shift, getting away from our typical postnatal treatment and really thinking outside the box and saying, wait a minute, maybe we should treat this tiny baby like a fetus. Maybe we should treat this baby as if they're still in the womb. And so our hope is that with this technique, we can support these babies for a short period of time safely. And during that period of time, allow their critical organs to develop to a point at which we could apply either some of our conventional treatment, or they might be able to breathe room air.